You've probably already seen GoDaddy's commercials, and although they do a great job of getting the attention of the male audience, it is likely that not everyone knows what this company does exactly. Well, primarily, they are a web hosting company that provides domain names and web space. But they also have a website builder package that you can see here. It bundles a domain name, email addresses, and point-and-click software to create a website. Let's take a look inside and check what's good and what's not so good about the GoDaddy website builder. We are now looking at the dashboard. From here, you can access various functions like web statistics and the backup manager. To actually work on your site, you have to start the site designer. The website editor. While editing, you can see the actual look of your website at any time. To edit a block of text, for example, simply click it. Once in editing mode, the black text designer interface will open up. The formatting options are very similar to Microsoft Word, so I'm sure you won't have any problems here. To add a new content block to your site, simply drag and drop it to where it says Drop Zone. In this toolbar, you can see the different types of elements available to add to your pages. We have, for example, media-related widgets like image galleries, as well as a video and audio player. Let's now add a contact form from the Tables and Forms category to our contact page. To do so, I drag and drop it to the page. To edit the content, I'll first need to click the form and then go to the black button on the left corner. Double-clicking would do the job as well. I've chosen this example because it shows a few general issues that we have with GoDaddy. Like a few other parts of this site builder, it looks like an interface invented in the 90s. And it's confusing. Not only are there no explanations for what all these options mean exactly, it also shows irrelevant information like action and method that cannot even be changed. But to be fair, it does the job and offers plenty of options. It's only not very sexy. Maybe they should ask the GoDaddy girl what she thinks about such an interface. Managing the navigation. Now this is where it starts to get even more complicated. There are two different places where you can change, add, and remove pages. The first one is inside the designer under the Pages section. By the way, the buttons you see here are not draggable anymore, even though they look the same as the other buttons. So we click Navigate to access the menu. Here you can create new main and sub pages. There are only two levels, as you can see here. The confusion starts if you try to change the hierarchy after you've created a page. You can't do this here for some reason. Instead, you need to leave the designer and go back to the dashboard. Now go to Organize Site, and you will find a menu that has a few more options. You can highlight one page and add another page underneath, like you see here. Layout and design. On a more positive note, we're going to look at their layouts. They look reasonably modern and feature different types of industries. You can also apply a filter to view specific sets of layouts. Let's go back to the editor and explore the style options. Through the style menu, you can fully customize background images, colors, and fonts. If you know your CSS, you have even more options to create a template exactly the way you want it to be. Conclusion. As you can probably guess by now, we aren't exactly fans of this product. Although GoDaddy has a nice range of features, we didn't manage to have a great user experience. The editor doesn't feel very consistent and is not particularly fast. At first glance, it doesn't look very difficult to use, but as you dig deeper, it gets more and more complicated. Another problem is that you can't expect much help from their support. Their employees seem as if they've never used the product. All they do is scan the keywords of your inquiry and send back canned answers from their support system. If you want to try it for yourself, you can choose the monthly payment option so that you're not directly tied into a one-year contract. Quite surprisingly, there is no free trial available. I hope you found this review useful. For GoDaddy alternatives, please check out websitetooltester.com. There you will find a ranking table of different website builders. And if you've enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up. Thank you.